And action! Hey, at the end of that logo sting, did you see the little line that was underneath my logo that says, "Your best is yet to come"? Well, I believe that wholeheartedly, that your best is yet to come. But there's another behavior that I've seen so often that it's concerning me. And I'm seeing that people are just giving up. They get in the mix, they get excited, then they give up. Now that could be people in their 50s, 60s, and 70s who believe that life is over for them. So it's time to just throw in the towel, go to work every day, pay your bills, get fat, you know, oversleep, these types of things. Who cares? I'm getting old. That's what it is. Seriously? That's what it is? Yuck. How about if you're a kid today, young 20s, 30s, you put all your attention into something so important to you, but along the way, it doesn't seem like you're gaining any traction, so you quit. I mean, it's not for you. Down life goes. Then it comes back up again when you have another idea. Then what do? You quit too easy. I always say this, and I believe this wholeheartedly, that, you know, the football field of life is riddled with running backs at the 1 yard line. They were so close to getting in the end zone, but they gave up too soon. They ran out of gas. You can't ever give up. A lot of these young kids coming into my business every day, getting ready to go off to college this summer, of course. You know, they're working here, local jobs, they're getting ready to go back to school. And it started to remind me of my time in school and the things that I went through as well. And I remember in just the semester before I got to graduate school, I had to take Organic Chemistry 1 and 2. I didn't do that well in those classes. It was difficult, and the teacher really had it in for me. I don't know if she was trying to inspire me or bust me down. Either way, she came to me after I took these two classes and she said to me, "You got a D and you got an F. Let me tell you right now, it's time for you to give up this facade, this dream of becoming a doctor, because you don't have it. You don't have what it takes to become a doctor." And wow, it's like in that one moment, my whole world just like went up in a puff of smoke. And I was like, holy crap, what do I do now? I'm already on the hook for all this money, for all these classes I've taken. What other skills do I have? What other desires do I have? And the answer was none. There was no plan B. I didn't have a plan B. There wasn't one. The whole plan was to get through an undergraduate, graduate education, become a doctor, and fulfill my dream of helping people. That's it. And I was about to give up when I walked down the end of the hallway and I turned back. I looked at that professor and I thought, you know, she doesn't even know me. Why the heck am I going to give in to what she's saying? That's bull. I'm not doing it. I'll tell you what I'm going to do then. I'm going to do this. I'm going to dig my heels in deep into the sand and I'm going to make this happen. I marched up to the guidance office, walked in there and said, "Do you have a summer course in organic chemistry?" They said, "Yes. We have Organic Chemistry 1 and 2 in the summer. Are you willing to take it? Do you want to take it?" I said, "Yes." How long are they? "They're 3 weeks each." I go, "You mean in 6 weeks, I'm going to have to master Organic Chemistry 1 and 2? And my guidance counselor looked at me and said, "Well, if you want to get these courses done before September, yes, that's what it's going to take." I'm like, holy crap, that's almost an insurmountable task. What did I do? I focused. I got tough. I got angry. And I got myself to class every single day. I studied and studied and studied until I got a 4.0 in both classes. I got an A in both. It taught me something, that whole scenario. Never, ever give up. You're going to get your butt whipped a million times on this journey called life to wherever you think you're going. You must fail over and over and over and fail yourself forward. Just got to keep going. You know, it was Les Brown, one of the great motivational speakers, that said, "If you're going to fall, fall on your back, because if you can look up, you can get up." You need to be inspired each day. And inspiration is just a reflection in the mirror away. Take a good look at yourself. You weren't put here to be second fiddle. You certainly weren't be put here to have somebody put a finger in your chest and tell you how to live your life. Now go out and live the damn life that you want. And pick yourself up. Never, ever, ever give up. Even in the darkest hour, you can't give up. You know, and speaking of the darkest hour, I watched that movie last night with Winston Churchill, the story about England in World War II during the Nazi Blitzkrieg. Let me tell you something. I was so inspired by watching Winston Churchill. I know it was a movie, but it was a, you know, historical docudrama of what happened. Winston Churchill was a hated man. Much of the men in Parliament didn't like him. He was definitely an outsider, and he had ideas and thoughts and ways of representing himself that irritated people. And he was crass. He was abrupt. He was a bully. But I'll tell you what, he got a nation together to decide that they would never live under a Nazi regime. They would rather die as free Englishmen. And that's what he brought out. He brought out that sense of, at all costs, you must go for it. You can never, ever give up. The time that you give up is the last 5 seconds that you take that breath and you find yourself at peace to go on to the next life. But if you want to live with inspiration and passion, they cannot exist if you quit. There should be no quit in you, even though there are moments when you feel as though that's your only option. It is not your only option. Your only option is victory, as Winston Churchill would say. And in your life, the only option is peace, joy, and happiness. And to get there, it's going to take a tremendous amount of work and energy, and you're going to need people around you to support you. But the day you give up is the day it's all over. Never, ever give up. And this week, I want you to start learning how to incorporate that into your life. Giving up is synonymous with overwhelm. Let's give you one simple exercise that you can do this week to regain some of your control and to get over the overwhelm. So I want you to take your work week and split it into two parts, your work day into two parts, the morning and the afternoon. And I want you to start trimming out the garbage in your life that you really don't need to deal with. You don't need to be checking your social account 50 times a day, checking your email 30 times a day. Stop it! In the morning, get one thing done. One thing that you absolutely need to accomplish, and get it done as fast as you possibly can. When someone comes into your office with a cup of coffee, say, thank you, I gotta get this done. I'm sorry, I don't have the time right now. Phone rings, you have to answer it, tell them this. Listen, I got 2 seconds, what do you need? Get the flack out of your life and get that thing done before noontime. By the afternoon, excuse me. You gotta get something else done, one thing. Just one thing. It has to get done at work, has to get done at home. This, above all things, must be done. It gives you that sense of drive, passion, desire, and accomplishment, because you can get a couple of things done. I can tell you this, there's been plenty of weeks in your life where you've just kept going and going and going to achieve nothing. Your days, 9 to 5, you're filling them up with stuff, but that stuff isn't getting you anywhere. It's just fluff, and you believe you need to fill up your day. Get back your control again. Get one thing done in the morning, another thing done in the afternoon, and then traverse through your day. Knowing that when you get home each night, you've got 2 major accomplishments completed today. Tomorrow, get up and do it again and again and again and again and again. Then you start to get victories, more and more victories in your life. You get more and more experience in going for it. And then this whole idea of, well, why bother? I just quit. That's for losers. Question is, are you a winner or are you a loser? Are you all in or are you a quitter? Because I'm calling you out right now. What kind of personality are you today? What do you want for your life? What do you want to set in motion for your children to emulate? What is it? Make that decision. Make it now. And by the way, in the comment section below, tell me where you're at right now. And that's what I got for you today. If you like this video, throw in a thumbs up, subscribe if you want to, but I'm going to be in your face every chance that I can because I want to see the best for you. I want to see you moving on, never giving up, and taking back the control that was tried to take from you. That's it. Dr. Pete, I'm out. I'll see you next week. Woo! What's up, everyone? Hey, if you're watching this video, I just made it.